Okay, so here's how this works. Take your cheap green paint, slop it on. Neatness doesn't count. Oh look, a lump, perfect. That can be a lump of grass. Not worried too much about it getting on the cork because that's going to get covered up with ballast eventually. I'm not going to try and go too far up onto the cork, but you know. So this paint is, I don't even know whether it's, I assume it's acrylic, I don't know, it's just green. No specific green, it's just a mist tint. The important part is that it's cheap. So here, where there's gaps or cracks in the foam, I've just taken some drywall mud and splattered it on there and filled cracks in, mostly so that the paint and then the glue later and the ground foam doesn't leak through and drip onto whatever's underneath, which in this case is a bunch of magazines in this area. And I've got some cheap garbage bags spread out over top of them so that if stuff does leak through, then it's not going to be a disaster, at least hopefully not, but why take the chance and why waste your material? Again, I'm not sure if you can see it on camera, but the drywall mud, when I put it on there, it's all lumpy and non-uniform because it really doesn't matter. Underneath here, any lumps will get covered with the ground foam and grass and weeds mixture. Uh-oh, my cheap $3 for $1 paintbrush is falling apart. Oh well, it might just become another lump in the grass. So I'm going fairly quickly because I don't want the paint to dry, because the paint is going to be my first layer of adhesive for the ground foam. Close enough for now, I'll deal with the rest of that later. And I've got paint on my hands, perfect. So now then, there's the ground foam mix. Scoop some up into a convenient little container just because it's easier. Sprinkle, sprinkle. Thick is fine. Doesn't matter that much as long as you're not getting it too horribly lumpy. And really, even if it is a little bit lumpy, who cares? This isn't a manicured suburban lawn. This is out behind a railway yard somewhere. A railway yard and industry off that way, there's a junkyard off that way, so it's not like this is going to get mowed more than what the fire department requires. Gets on the rails, I can dust off later. That's not a problem. And over down in there, shadowing myself perfect down in there. Not too worried that's going to get filled with ballast. Doesn't take too long to look reasonable. So, once that's done, we let it dry for a day or so. Once it's dry, it looks like this area back here, which is, as they say on the cooking shows, one I prepared earlier. I did that about a day or so ago. This back here, can we see it? No, it's off camera. Okay, we'll worry about that later. That's basically beyond this is stuff that I've done a decade ago. So it's lighter now, it's dusty, it's not going to match exactly. I'll plant some trees there or something to disguise the fact that there's a line. So now then, the next step, which I'll show on this in a second. One short readjust later, I'm back, and so over here we've got the area that I did the paint and ground foam routine on last night. This is still wet, so I'm going to try not to lean on it and get my elbow all green, because that would be awesome. I was mentioning before the cut that this is sort of the line between the new and the old. The old is darker. It's going to look a little bit darker anyway once I get the glue on it. This is just basic white glue, cut 50-50 or so with water. It's not rocket surgery, it's not an exact science. And this is just water, they call it wet water. It's water with a couple of drops of dish detergent in it or soap. What it does is it lets the glue flow easier. So, I'm just gonna mist this in here. If I spray it too hard, it's going to blow any of the ground foam out of the way that's not already stuck down by the paint. So I want to get a good saturation on there. I'm getting some of my sky backdrop, which itself has issues. You notice right here that there's a drastic change in the color of the sky. That's not a meteorological oddity. That's because this has been sitting here fading in the light for... where am I? Camera through. This part's been sitting fading in the light for a decade or more, and this I put up last week. It's just poster board from the dollar store, 3 for a buck. Or at least that's what it was when I bought them, and they've been sitting in the closet ever since. Getting a bit of water on them. Oh well. You want this fairly damp, just so that the moisture holds it all together into one big mass until you can get the glue on. That sort of looks good-ish. So we'll take this, now then the glue. Just put a bit into one of my handy-dandy little cups. Ah, I knocked something over. Oh well. If it's broken, I'll just rebuild it. So now then, just take some of the glue stuff. We're going to completely soak this thing. It's going to turn white. Hopefully, oh, there's a crack in the foam there that I didn't plaster, because I was in such a hurry to get at this. Hopefully my garbage bag underneath catches it, otherwise I've got a bunch of magazines that are all glued together. But when this settles down and the glue dries, it's going to make it all nice and crusty and hard. Back when I was with the modular group with a traveling layout, everything was so glued down, we could hold the modules upside down or sideways or whatever, and nothing would move. Which is exactly what you're looking for. So, I'm just going to keep doing this. I don't want to drop it on too fast. I don't want to squirt the unstuck grass out of the way. Yes, this is time consuming. If the nozzle on my glue bottle wasn't broken, I could use it as a faster vein here, and I might just do that. Now, that's clumping up a little bit, which means it's not wet enough. When you see the that happening. I don't know whether you can see that or not. You can see it beading, the glue beading up on the surface rather than soaking in quickly. That means it's just not wetted enough. And I'll just keep doing this. That's part of the reason why I'm only doing a chunk at a time, so that I can sort of get some, see a sense of accomplishment rather than doing the whole thing all at once. Well, partly because I'm lazy, but partly because I like seeing a chunk done in manageable sizes. That's not wet enough back there. Okay, I'll edit and come back in a while here. Actually, this nozzle is not so broken that I can't use it. Can you look underneath where I am right now and make sure that plastic bag is still taped to the wall? Mm-hmm. Is it?
Yep, it's still taped.
Okay. Okay. That whole area is glued. You can see that it's very white now. That's just the white glue. It's just common white glue like every kid uses in school. It's gonna dry clear. And we'll be back sometime to, once that's dry, probably tomorrow. All right, so a few days have passed. The thinned out glue has dried on the area over here, and the paint has dried on this area here. So you can see that the glued area is a little bit darker now. It's just the way it works out. Oh goody, whack the tripod. Nicely done. And there's still a bit of a difference between the old area and the new area, but it's not quite as drastic. I sprayed a bit of water onto the old area that had the dust on it to try and sink the dust in a little bit and get it out of the way. I don't know, it looks reasonable. Next step is to add some small shrubs and stuff. Okay, so got my little container of thinned out white glue again, eyedropper and some tweezers. So I got some clump ground foam, which is, I don't know, I think it was some sort of woodland scenic stuff. This looks sort of like that. And I've also got some medium grass colored woodland scenic foliage clusters, which is, it's kind of like a block of green foam, and you can just break off whatever size chunks you want for little shrubs and hedges. So I'll just get busy dipping that in glue and sticking that down here and there, mostly at random. I mean, it doesn't matter too much if you get, okay, that one's gonna be useless, you can't see it, but that's just in by the bridge abutment. Aren't really all that special, they're just so I don't get glue on my fingers, but then gluing the tweezers to myself stuff anyway, so. And this is probably going to need another swatch of, that one didn't get much on it. Probably going to need some more glue at some point. But that's not a big hairy deal. Obviously when you're done doing this, you're going to clean the track. Let's see, oh no, that's a little bit different green. Sometimes it's a little hard to tell the difference between clumps and clusters. And these are just going fairly random. This is, like I said earlier, this is kind of an overgrown area that is off the edge of the railway. Not if I decide to plant buildings here at some time later, I can just tear these up, or they can be part of it. Bubbles in the glue. Oh well, just mush it around in there. And again, white glue for obvious reasons, because it's not going to, or it's going to dry clear eventually. So that's that. I'll throw a few more in there, and that's basically that. That's nothing to it. I think I figured out where that clump ground foam came from. I had another one of these kits earlier, and I'll zoom out a little bit, which is where those trees back there actually came from. And the leftovers, I think, is what ended up in my clump ground foam. Okay, so that was, there's the stuff from the container, and here's some of the stuff from the kit. I guess that is it, okay. And then just for color reference, there's the Woodland Scenic stuff, which is a hair darker, I think. But my old colorblind eyes can't tell you which one's greenier. They're just different. Okay, so be it. I guess I should get to building those trees then. So there's what's in that tree kit that I showed you a second ago. Camera, hurry, there you go. So there's a bag of the foliage. There's a little bottle of Aileen's brand tacky glue, whatever, it's glue. And then there's three tree armatures complete with useless bases that aren't obviously gonna get used. When I made these three trees over here from another copy of the same kit, I just poked a little hole in the ground foam and the foam and jammed that tree in there. And here it is, a tree. Well, sort of. Okay, I was just gonna make this tree and then magically edit it in up there, but then I decided not to be a lazy dork and actually tape it, so maybe somebody might learn something. Maybe somebody might learn not to do it the way I'm doing it. So, just spoon out a bit of glue into there. I've already twisted the tree up and I've got it in my handy dandy little helping hands unit here. This isn't, as you might be able to guess, that little tiny bottle of Aileen's tacky glue, because since it's been sitting on the shelf for over a decade, it's turned into a solid lump. Let's spread a couple more of these branches out a little bit more. Perfection? No, doesn't need to be perfect. Why? Because it's a tree. Nature's not perfect. It's completely random. So if there's a branch that bends in an odd direction, as long as it's not like defying gravity or something, then you're good to go. Like this one here, I'm not sure if you can see it or not, but it's got a nasty little kink in it. Don't care. So it's paint a bit of glue onto some of these branches. Just a tip. Why? Because leaves don't grow out of the middle of the branch in a real tree. They grow off the end. So this stuff, I'm just kind of tease it out a little bit. Grab it onto that blob. mush it on. Mush some on down there. And again, the beauty of the white glue mixture, it dries clear. You can hide a multitude of sins in that. Yeah, there's that, some falling off, excellent. Let's make some of that up onto there. Oh. You gonna stay? Okay, there's, after the application of the first bunch of clusters, I'm going to let that dry, see what happens. I'll probably add a little bit of the thin glue on there, just to, or maybe gob some more bits in there just to make it all stick together, and then I'll add some more bits and pieces to thicken it up, because right now it's a pretty sparse tree. Okay, it's later. I am back. The tree is foliated and the glue's 90-ish% dry. Time for planting. Where should it go? Let's put it about there. Gob some glue on there. Here it is, a tree. Now I'm just to go and make a bunch more. That's another project for another week.